We know pretty well what atmospheric rivers are. They're rivers in the sky, and in California, it can be up to half the rainfall, and when they're extreme, can cause most of the flooding. They're relatively large, but some of the smaller scale nuances within the atmospheric rivers can really change the forecast. I'm Julie Kalansky, and I'm a climate scientist here at Scripps. This January sequence of atmospheric rivers that we had was very unique in terms of how quickly one atmospheric river came after the next. It's something that we really haven't seen in the historical record for that long of period of time. One of the things that has been developed at Scripps is the atmospheric river scale, and so it's an indication of when it's most likely going to be more beneficial versus more hazardous. We use a whole suite of different sorts of instruments and different technologies to study atmospheric rivers. The really neat ones are the airplanes that fly through atmospheric rivers and drop instruments through them to measure them, and those actually go into forecasting models. We also get to study the impacts of climate change. On land, we also have instruments that look up into the sky to measure how much water vapor or water's in the sky and the winds and how atmospheric rivers change once they come on land. I wanted to make sure that I could work in climate, and as I started talking to people at Scripps, I was very pleased to understand how much work is going on into understanding climate change and the impact of that. And I had an opportunity to work with the Center of Western Weather and Water Extremes exploring that and atmospheric rivers, and an ideal match. I feel like the work we're doing, however idealistic it sounds, is helping. In our corner of the world and what we work on, we're making progress towards a more resilient state.